Hello everyone, thanks for tuning in again. If you have a Google Home, then I'll almost guarantee that you've been looking forward to continued conversations by Google. Now this feature has been rolled out and I'm going to show you today how to use that feature, how to get it enabled, and of course I'm going to show you a few of the quirks about it that you might not know right out of the box. So let's get going. Google's continued conversations feature is relatively easy to get set up. I'm going to show you on an iPhone here in the Google Home application. You just need to head to the menu and then more settings. Once inside there, you're going to see your preferences menu option, and then you're going to head into continued conversation. Now in this section of the app, you can see which devices you own, where this is available or going to be available on. Continued conversations only works on English US devices. So you have to set your language to that and then they will show up here in this once they have the right firmware on board. I had to have 1.32 at least or better in order to get this working. So you just need to take the slider at the top to the right, and then you've enabled continued conversation on your device. That's it. Now, once I head out of my preferences, I can slide down to the devices. Here's where your assistant language is. I went into my basement home device, and you can see I have English United States selected. Even though I'm in Canada, this is still working for me. I just have to have that language selected. So let me show you a demo and then I'll show you some of the nuances about this with the Google Home.
Hey Google, what's the weather like?
Currently in New York City, it's 81 and partly cloudy. Today, it'll be partly cloudy with a forecasted high of 82 and a low of 62.
And what about tomorrow?
In New York City tomorrow, it'll be mostly sunny with a high of 77 and a low of 64.
Is there rain in the forecast?
No, it won't rain tomorrow in New York City.
Thanks, Google.
No problem.
Now here, just on the Google Home support page, again, continued conversation is available only when your assistant language is set to English. You're going to wake your device with the normal wake words that you use. The only difference is once Google Home has completed answering your question or your query, it's going to listen for about 8 seconds or up to 8 seconds for any follow-up questions. What I've noticed using the device is it's much less than 8 seconds unless your room is quite noisy. Now, how do you end this? Because otherwise it will continue to listen for 8 seconds and continue the conversation. So you can end it by saying, thank you, thanks Google, or I'm done. Any of those will stop the device, which you saw me use in the demo. There are a few things you can't use with continued conversation. Basically, they call it an active session. So during a phone call, during alarms or timers, when they're actually going off, when it's ringing, or when you're listening to music or video on your Google Home. One thing to note is the only visual notification you get is that the lights on the top of the Google Home will stay on when the device is listening. This doesn't change anything from before, it's just that you will notice that those lights remaining on for much longer now. One last thing to tell you about, this is pretty interesting. One person can ask a question and then a second person can ask the follow-up question. So you can basically have a multi-person conversation with Google Home. The only thing is you'll need to be wary of asking for personal information once you have your voice assistant trained to your voice. If person one asks about like a calendar event and then person two within that same query with continued conversation enabled asks about their calendar, that's not going to work. You're going to need to basically stop the session and then let that second person go ahead and ask the question.